Now that I have all of my components selected and have determined the control method, it is time for me to assemble and wire all of the devices. I'll also need to set up my hardware configuration jumpers and dip switch settings. Let's see how this is done. Before I cover the schematic diagram I used for wiring the control system, let me review the components that were put together to make up the motion control system I will be using to control my linear lead screw slide. The system includes the DirectLOGIC DLO5 micro PLC. I used part number D0-05DD that provides DC inputs and outputs. A high-speed counter interface module, part number H0-CTRIO, is installed into the available expansion slot on the DLO5 PLC. The SureStep stepping system components I selected include a micro-stepping drive, part number STP-DRV-4035, a NEMA 23 stepping motor, part number STP-MTR-23079, a power supply, part number STP-PWR-4805, and an extension cable, part number STP-EXT-020. The Seymour micrographic touch panel I am using is a part number EA1-S3ML, and I have added a Seymour serial port with DC power adapter, part number EA-MGSP1, that plugs into my panel to provide a second serial port, and is also a convenient method to power the panel from a 24 volts DC source. I complete the Seymour components by using a part number EA-2CBL Seymour communications cable to connect between my panel and the DLO5 PLC. If I didn't mention it earlier, I am using this serial port with DC power adapter to give me a second communications port to allow me to have communications port 1 on the panel connected to my programming PC during development. The last of the components I have selected include an AutomationDirect Rhino 24 volt DC power supply, part number PSC-24-030. Providing power to the Seymour panel and the proximity sensors I am using. Speaking of the proximity sensors, I have selected an AutomationDirect ProSense part number APS4-12S-E-D. I am using the proximity sensors to detect my axis home position and also my over travel limits. The linear lead screw slide I am using is a commercial unit with a pitch of 0.125 inches per revolution and a total slide travel of 300 millimeters. Shown here is a wiring schematic of the components that I used for the motion control demonstration unit. The schematic shows the DLO5 PLC with its serial communications connection to the Seymour micrographic panel, its I/O connections to the over-travel proximity sensors, the CTRIO high-speed counter interface module with its output pulse and direction connections to the SureStep drive, and the home proximity sensor connection to a CTRIO input. The linear slide with its lead screw is represented, showing the location of the SureStep stepping motor and the home and over-travel proximity sensors. Next, I will set the jumpers on the CTRIO module. The module's jumpers can be configured for either DC voltage syncing or sourcing operation. In our example, we will be syncing the pulse and direction signals that feed the SureStep STP-DRV-4035 micro-stepping motor driver. I place the four jumpers over the set of pins to the left as shown here. Let me point out that the H0-CTRIO module has one input channel, which consists of four optically isolated input points. The input terminals are labeled A, B, C, D, and are common to terminal M. The inputs can be wired so that all four either sync or source current. No jumper selection required. It's all in how they are wired. The module also has two optically isolated outputs. The output terminals are labeled Y0 and Y1 and are common to terminal YC. Do not confuse the CTRIO's Y0 and Y1 labeling with the DLO5 PLC's outputs with the same designations. They are not the same. The outputs can be wired to either sync or source current. The sync source jumper selection we just made sets both outputs to the same option. Sourcing outputs must be wired so positive current flows into the YC terminal and then out the Y0 or Y1 terminal. Syncing outputs must be wired so positive current flows into the Y0 or Y1 terminals and then out the YC terminal, so just the opposite of sourcing. Source operation is the factory default setting for the outputs, but my application, I needed to set them for sync operation. The STP-DRV-4035 drive includes a 9-position dip switch. The dip switch is used to set the drive's various parameters, which include a self-test function, micro-stepping resolutions of 400, 1,000, 2,000, or 10,000 steps, current reduction at idle, and the step motor's phase current. The SureStep drive includes a self-test feature which aids in troubleshooting the stepping system. To use it, slide dip switch position 1 towards the label marked test. The stepping motor will slowly rotate 1/2 revolution forward and then 1/2 revolution backwards. This motion will repeat until the dip switch is returned to the off position. The self-test will use half-step mode and ignore any input signals on the step and direction terminals. The enable input will continue to function normally. Precisely controlling the amount of current in each phase at each step position allows the steps to be electronically subdivided, which produces the ability to microstep. The drive can be configured for half-step operation or one of the three different microstep resolutions. These are the 1/5, 1/10, or 1/50th microsteps. In a typical 1.8 degree step motor, this will equate to 400, 1,000, 2,000, or 10,000 steps per revolution. Dip switch positions 2 and 3 are used to set the resolution as shown here. The SureStep drive's current reduction feature can be enabled to reduce the stepping motor's current by 50% anytime the motor is not moving. Drive heating is reduced by about 50% by using current reduction, and the feature lowers motor heating by 75%. Slide dip switch position 4 towards the label marked 50% idle to enable current reduction as shown here. Be aware that the stepping motor's holding torque will be reduced. The last 5 positions of the dip switch, positions 5 through 9, are used for setting the motor current of the stepping motor. The value of current for each position is printed adjacent to the dip switch. There is always a base current of 0.4 amps. To add to the base current, slide the appropriate switches toward their labels marked on the drive's printed circuit board. The factory default is set for 2.8 amps, which happens to be the current rating for the stepping motor, part number STP-MTR-23079, that I am using in my demonstration. Shown here is a summary of all of the drive's dip switch settings. The self-test position is off. The micro-stepping resolution is set for 1/10, which will allow me to use 200 steps per revolution. The current reduction position is on to allow 50% current reduction at idle. The motor current per the stepping motor nameplate data has been confirmed for 2.8 amps. In part 5, I will get into the programming, starting with the CTRIO configuration, along with creating motion profiles using the CTRIO Workbench utility.